Hi guys, in this tutorial we are going to see what is Vertex and how to develop reactive application using Vertex. So normally Vertex was developed by VMware, now it's part of Eclipse Foundation. So Eclipse Vertex is a toolkit, or you can say it's a library for building reactive application on top of JVM, like Kotlin and Vertex. With these two we can develop the reactive application on top of JVM. Eclipse Vertex is event driven and non-blocking. Event driven and non-blocking means whenever we are sending request from the client, it should not wait to get the response, it will process the other stop. And you can see here, this means your application can handle a lot of concurrency using a small number of kernel threads. Vertex lets your app scale with minimal hardware. And Vertex is polyglot. Polyglot in the sense, you can use Vertex with multiple languages. It's not stick to a particular language, means we can say it's platform, like language independent. So you can use it using Java, JavaScript, Scala, Kotlin. And Vertex is unopinionated. It means it will not like force a developer to use their predefined interface or predefined implementation method. You can write a code the way you want. So you can check here, Vertex is lightweight and its size is 650 KB, and Vertex is fast, and Vertex is modular. When you need more bits, just add the bits you need and nothing more. Vertex is simple but not simplistic. Vertex allow you to create powerful apps simply. This is the official site. And the main purpose of use this Vertex to develop the reactive application using functional programming language. Okay, so for more details you can refer this official site. Let's check in Wikipedia. Eclipse Vertex is polyglot event driven application framework that's runs on the Java virtual machine. Okay, and you can see the supported language, and you can find here the history, all the release version. Okay, so let's develop a small application using Vertex, and we can check how it behaves and how we can expose our service using Vertex. Okay, so let's create a application. I am creating here standalone Java application. Group ID com.javatechie.app. Artifact ID, I am giving it Vertex. Something like core or example. Finish it. Let me set Java 8 and build path. Set the compiler also Java 8. Okay, now let's change this application name, something like Vertex example. Okay, So first we need to create Vertex instance. Then using Vertex instance we can create the server and we can expose our application and we can specify the routing mechanism there. Okay, so let's create one by one. Create Vertex. So to work with Vertex we need to add the Vertex dependency, that is a Vertex core. You can use the latest release version. I am using 3.5.1. Okay, now create the, it's not loaded yet. You can find here Vertex. There is one static factory method in Vertex to create the Vertex instance. Now create server HTTP server using Vertex. You can check this HTTP server comes from Vertex API. And you can create the server using Vertex create HTTP server. Okay. Now we created the Vertex instance, we created the server. Now we need to specify the URL to redirect our application, like how we are using request mapping or get mapping in MVC. So similar way, there is a class called router. Using this router you can specify our URL to redirect our business. You need to pass the Vertex instance here. Now write a handler, means we will specify the router there. Okay, router something like, I'm giving handler 1 router dot route. Okay, then provide the handler for that, and we can check handler parameter is routing context. Okay, using the lambda here. Handler 1, 2, okay, it will be the route. Now here we need to create the server response, HTTP server response coming from Vertex, and that response you will get from routing context dot response. Okay, now in server response set the chunk to true, and if you want you can set or you can write some message, something like I am giving welcome to Java Techie, and just end it. Okay, we provided the handler and we are printing some dummy message on console. Now let's define the port for that particular server. Server dot listen. Let me give the port 90 98. Okay, and here we need to specify the request handler, and provide the router here. Provide the router, okay, and give the dot. Now you can expose your this service on port 9098. Okay, so let's run it. Okay, now application is up. So let's run this. Localhost, you are able to see welcome to Java Techie. Okay, so here we didn't develop any web application, simply it's a standalone application, and using this Vertex we are able to expose our service. This is just dummy service. I just want to print some statement here. I don't have any business to show you. So with this you can expose a service. Okay, and here we didn't specify any URL mapping here. Let me specify some URL. Get message. Okay, now let me restart. Now you can access this service using this URL. Now if I will hit, I will get 404, resource not found. Now provide the URL, get message. We are able to get the message here. Okay, similar way you can specify the method type here. Let me specify this method as get. For post you can specify it as post. So let's check with get. Restart this application, and it's, you can check here how it is faster. It is not taking much time to load the application. Now let's hit it. Now let's change it to post, so that only post request you can access this. Let me restart. Okay, let me stop, then again restart. It's already running on port. Let me stop. Okay, now it's up. So now if I will access here, I will get the 404 resource not found, as this is not a get. Okay, now let's test same in postman with method type post. Okay, with post we are able to access it. Change it to get. We are getting resource not found. Similar way, if you want to mention like your media type, consumes or produces, how you are writing @ produces or consumes whenever you are using any REST-G or JERSI specific implementation, here also you can specify produces. You can specify here */json. Okay, let me stop and restart. should be post. Welcome to Javatiki and it's on format JSON. If you in header section, you need to specify content type this is just plain text message, so it's not reflecting the JSON format. Let me create a class, then we'll return that object. Okay, define some field int id, string name. Okay, provide the getter setter. Providing constructor using field, providing default constructor. Okay, now here I'm going to return directly user object, something is there, JSON dot pretty encode prettily, and here I will give the new user object with field something like 567 and name Java. Okay, now let's run it. We'll get JSON response. Okay, application is up. Now hit it, we are getting JSON response. Okay, here just change. Okay, so this is the way we can develop our web service, or we can expose our service using Vertex, and we can customize our media type format, and we can specify the method type. Okay, so in my next video I will show you how to perform the get mapping or post mapping with JSON data and Vertex. Like complete RESTful web services we will develop on next session. Okay, that's it about this particular video. If anyone have any concern or doubt, you can add a comment. Thanks for watching this video.